Hi everybody, Bum Chef is back, and today we're living with Coca. We're living with Coca. Let me read this again. We are cooking with liver. Liver. Best origin of every. There is a lot of things to do with liver. First thing and most important thing is to look at it, smell it, and puke. Cooking with liver is there are many possibilities. One is chopped liver. Chopped liver. This is a traditional Jewish dish with typically Jewish hundreds of rules. As you can see here, there are cosmic energies already fighting against each other, because here's some sweet cream. I will better place it somewhere else. In the Jewish rule set of cooking, it's totally forbidden to bring any dairy foods like milk, cheese, cream, together with the actual meat. Liver is in this case the meat. I don't even know how the real word is. It's just forbidden. It's prohibited. However, this is why we put those things apart. Chopped liver. It will be done with. We will fry the liver, we will cook the eggs, and we will steam cook some onions. And in the end, we will chop all together. This is part one of cooking with liver. Part two, happening at the same time, so it's not really part two, is the totally opposite. We have last night, about 8 hours ago, totally disgusting. I have put the liver into milk for 8 hours. So this is a Jew would probably run away when he sees this. Scream in agony, and this liver sucked up with milk, we will make a sweet dish, a sweet liver. Bum Chef original, I've never heard of or read of something alike somewhere. We will fry the liver in slices with onions and mushrooms, and of course the sweet cream. That's all for today, so let's start. We will first put the eggs in a little pot. Then we will put some hot water over it, waiting for it to boil. And activate all the oven plates. So, how do we start? Peeling of the onions for a good start. Water is ready. The eggs will cook for about 10 to 15 minutes now. The onions, super. After being peeled off, will be steam cooked. As I said, I've got my trustworthy bamboo steam cooker for this.
If you don't have something like this, you can just use this, whatever this is called, and put this over a pot and let the steam go through like this. Just quarter them, slice them in quarters. 1, 2, 3, 4. And a second. And the most practical thing is, I put this thing over the pot with the eggs. So I can cook two things in just one pot. Small raisins. Use the rest of the water for some tea, of course. And then continue. It's also important for the Jewish that the cooking device, like this pan, has never been in contact with some dairy food. Meaning you shouldn't have made some cheese omelette in the same pan in which you want to cook the liver or fry the liver. It's not allowed. So I think I've never done some dairy foods in this pan. The back room. So next step, heat up some oil. Sunflower oil for both. Nothing prohibited about this. And we start with the milk liver. Try to get at least some of the milk away. And we slice it in slices. The liver can easily suck up every liquid because a liver is like a sponge. It's an organ like a sponge. It sucks up the function of the liver is to suck up the blood, and this blood is getting cleaned. It's getting cleaned inside the liver and leaves the liver detoxed. The liver is detoxing the blood. So if you drink a lot, of course the liver has a lot to do, and eventually if the liver has got too much to do, it will lose its function, and then you have a really big problem. And because of that, because liver and alcohol is a really bad combination, we will later use some rum to flame all the liver. This liver, the non-Jewish liver. Oh, of course, it's not pork, it's beef liver. But you can also use chicken or anything, at least as long as it's not pig. In the end, you can use whatever you want. But if you have, let's say you have a Jewish guest, or you want to make it just traditional, just as I am intending here, don't use pork. The oil is hot now, and we put the liver in the pan. Now I'm gonna wash my hands, so no milk will come near the Jewish liver, let's call it that, like that. My hands are clean, so now I can touch this liver, and we let it as it is and put it in the other pan.
And we immediately reduce the heat to like half. Oh, it's gonna be a sweaty job today.
Mushrooms. So we slice up mushrooms next. Just like that, not smaller. They will, when in the pan, they will lose all the liquid, all the water, and shrink anyway. They will shrink like this. It's no need to cut them smaller. There really is some dirt left because those mushrooms are fresh from the field. But we don't care because first we are bums and second all this gets heat up so high every germ will die. And mix everything up. Make sure the liver is getting the same heat from both sides by flipping them over from time to time. Onions are cooking, eggs are cooking, liver is frying. We need another onion. Let's take two. Most people know what an onion tastes like. But what they don't know is that it's actually a sweet taste. If you fry them not super long, not like that they get really brown, but just begin to shine. Just until they get a soft glance, they will become sweet. If you fry them brown or even black, of course they will taste like a bit bitter, but since we are doing a sweet liver here, we just cook them until they get a soft, shiny glance and they release all their sweetness. Slice them smaller as you can see. Mixing everything up. So now we wait until everything gets fried a bit more. And we are back. As you can see, we have changed our setup a bit here. First we have the two special ingredients. Let's start with rum. It's just Jamaican rum, as everybody knows it. Good. We will flame the sweet liver because rum is a sweet thing and we make it sweet. There we go. And what you need to know if you want to flame some food. It needs to be warm. The bottom needs to be warm and just let it heat up a few seconds. And we're gonna light it. I don't know if the camera can catch this, but it's actually burning. I may have lost some hair on my hand, but who needs hair on the hand? This will give this dish additional sweetness. And we let it cook some more. Second special ingredient for the Jewish liver, the chopped liver, how it is named, reality is, there are many names for this. It's lard or schmalz, it's the German name and also the Jewish name. Jews call it, or Jiddish if you want, schmalz, lard. And it's with grapes, or another name is Greidens, which is another Jiddish word to say. And of course it's not from a pork, from pig, it's goose. We want to make it Jew-friendly.
for, and it's a bunch have self-made grease, lard. This means there are, oh God, Ort Urtica. Urtica, I really don't know how to spell it right. Urtica. It's a herb growing all over the world, but especially in German forests. And we add a big spoon of it. And at this point we can reduce the heat on both pans to zero. This is actually not black, it's a deep brown, and this is really needed. You want to fry them this brown. Okay, last ingredient for the sweet liver, the sweet cream. The sweet cream is really liquid. We let it in the pan until it gets sticky. Needs to get hardly fluid, sticky liquid. Okay. And we have changed the setup to a new board because just as we actually didn't need it, I was prepared. Because we're gonna chop the liver now, and of course it needs to be according to Jewish tradition a board that has never been in touch with cheese, milk or anything alike. We place the onions on it and the eggs. Important info, you need to cool those eggs under ice cold water. The longer you cool them and the cooler the water is, the easier those eggs get to peel. Why is this? The eggs inside the shell shrink. When they shrink because of the cold water, and when they shrink away from the shell is, can easily be picked up. It's that easy. So cool them really, really down. And by the way, you don't burn your fingers if you cool them down. So let's peel those eggs. And I'll do one for the camera. You can see how easy and fast this goes. If you have cooled them down. And now comes the fun part. We gonna chop those, and now I almost used the same knife I did to cut the milky liver. We won't use this, we won't use a Santaku knife. As you can tell, a sushi knife. I've never done some cheese or milk with it. Half those eggs. And now go totally insane on it. When you're done, put everything in a big bowl. And we repeat those steps with the liver. Will be of course easier if you slice them in bigger parts for starting and then chop it. And this is the last liver we are chopping down. It's hot. Who would have thought? Liver coming out of the pan is hot. It gets easier the bigger the knife is you use, of course. But it's impossible with a knife like this. The finer and smaller the dices are, the better. But it takes so much time. I won't cut the tiny shreds. Okay, that should be enough, at least for my standards. And now for seasoning. Both dishes only need pepper and salt additionally. Of course, the onions are seasoning as well. It's like a herb. Herbs are seasoning. And the rest here. If you don't actually know what you do, be careful with the seasoning. Give it a taste every now and then. This is becoming good, all sticky as I intended it to be. And we mix up the chopped liver with the eggs and the onion. I really don't know who invented this thing. Look at it. What is this? Is this for mentally handicapped or I don't know. And rather than mixing, I'm also mashing this, because this needs to be a cream in the end. So mash it. I give it a taste. Really good, I like it. In about 5 minutes of mixing and mashing, we are ready to serve. Okay, time to serve. I have to admit, I went a bit overboard with this bread. You can use any bread, as long as it's dark and full grain would be nice. But as I said, I went a bit overboard. This is walnut buckwheat bread, the most expensive they had in the shop. I had to beg hours to get enough change to really could afford this. And we put the cream. As you can see, it really has become a cream. Sticky cream, just as intended. A big portion on it. Thick. Everybody likes thick nowadays. Sick girls, sick chopped liver, why not? Now, ain't that something? Incredible. While continuing eating this and going on with the serving, this is a sweet liver. Also, it became just as intended, just as I made it up in my mind. If this is not clear, this is the first time, actually the first time I cooked this. It just existed in my head before. And let's give it a taste. Really great. If I had to decide, I would take both, because why not? And remember, if you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.